using your powers takes a lot out of you. I saw the gun and I just...
Rose, you don't have to apologize. I enjoyed seeing that old mugger's face once he realized who he was up against. It reminded me of old times.
That wasn't too much for you? You're gonna be okay?
I'm a little tired, but I'll recover soon enough.
You know, I didn't know you could do all that much anymore. I had heard your powers were killing you.
They might have been, back the way I was using them when I was the stopper. But that much just now, I don't think will cause any harm.
Do you miss it?
Very little, if I'm honest.
Really? You don't miss being the hero, stopping the villain, saving lives? I saw the look on your face, even as you were about to collapse. You liked seeing that mugger run off like a scared child.
Okay, so I'll admit, it was easier than handing over my wallet. And it was funny as hell. But that's just not how I want to spend my nights anymore. Being a hero had its good points, but it was like a part-time job for me. Something I did in high school, and then I moved on.
I guess it's not for everyone.
You miss it, don't you?
It was who I was. Now I'm nothing. Of course I miss it.
You're not nothing.
I know, but... back when I was Mr. Mind, I never stopped to face the doubt in my head. It was hectic and exhausting, and there was always some villain trying to take over the world, or some apocalypse going to end it all. But it was exciting, and it felt so good to help people. Anytime I messed up, I bottled it up inside and moved on to the next crisis. I lost myself in being a hero, and then I lost it all.
You know, I never did hear you talk much about what happened.
What's there to say? I was heading to some warehouse that he turned into a lab, like I'd done a dozen times before. Then, the next thing I know, I'm waking up in a hospital bed. First time I'd ever been the one waking up in a hospital room. They said there was a weird explosion, a strange burst of energy, and that I'd been in a coma for 4 months. You know, doctors didn't tell me what they suspected, and what I quickly figured out. My powers were gone.
And you don't remember anything about what happened?
Nothing. You know, I've given up on trying to pry it out of my brain. I'm working on accepting that I'm never going to be a superhero again. Now I'm just working on what I can do with my life.
You know, I've been talking with Charlotte, and she told me that she's been trying to get you to spend some time on monitor duty. It doesn't take any powers to run the comm system. You're not too shabby at coordination and strategy, and you know everyone in the league already.
I don't know anyone.
Okay, so there have been a few new members since you left.
That's not what I mean. Looks like Liberty's torch is on the scene. I wonder how Charlotte knew.
New app that Technobility has been trying out. I don't know how well they put out a public version, but the response time is impressive.
I didn't even think to call the cops. Some use Zion.
Still holding yourself responsible for everything I see. Why are you so hard on yourself?
Nick! I knew that Gene had sent the call, but I didn't know that you were going to be here. I couldn't stop the mugger. I'm so sorry. But I thought I'd check on you here.
Yeah, we're fine. We were having a pleasant stroll before we were rudely interrupted.
Which got us talking about old times and how useful Nick would be running comms at League headquarters.
I've been telling Nick how great he'd be. He knows everyone.
I don't know anyone. Half of the League is costumes and powers to me. I don't even know most of their real names.
Nick, most of us do keep secret identities.
And most of them trusted their secret identities to Mr. Mike. Not that I could be bothered to remember.
So you're bad with names.
That's not it. Back when I was a hero, I flew around the city saving people. You know, it's only now that I realize how shallow my life was. I never made time to have any real friendships. I knew a lot of people, and it felt like I had a lot of friends, but, you know, it's only after the accident that I realized I know more about you and Charlotte than I ever knew about y'all when we were working together.
And that's a good thing, right?
Yeah. But it makes me realize how shallow my life was before, and how empty it is now.
Well, we're here to help you fill it up with things, if that's what you want. I still
super speed and trying to figure things out about life that I didn't even know before, it became overwhelming. Eventually, I just stopped going to class.
Why didn't you tell us about this?
I was embarrassed. You know, I couldn't explain why I was having panic attacks. I didn't want you coming in and fixing things. Not when I didn't know what needed fixing. You know, I was terrified of getting worse, so I didn't want to make any changes. You know, I should have made time for my life when I had powers. I should have focused more on how normal people manage their lives. I shouldn't have procrastinated so much. I should have spent more time on physical therapy. I should have spent less time on physical therapy. I was crushed under a huge pile of should.
Nick, I'm so sorry. I had no idea. What can I do to help?
I don't know. I wish I did. I'm working on things, I promise.
I want to help, Nick.
I know you do. I don't know what to tell you. I could use some time to think. I didn't expect to have this conversation today.
Why don't Charlotte and I go dispose of this gun?
You'll be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks.
Let me know if there's anything I can do.
I'm glad you finally told some of your friends.
Yeah, it's great. Kind of weird, though. I wasn't ready for this.
Are the antidepressants helping?
With the depression, yes. I'm not so sure they're working with my anxiety. Should I just assume you know everything?
Not everything. When your depression got worse, I did start keeping closer tabs on you, though.
You know, I should probably be offended at your invasion of my privacy.
Probably. I make no apologies. The world's a better place with you in it, Nick. Powers or not.
You know, I wish I was sure of that.
You weren't even sure of that when you were Mr. Might. It's one of the reasons you worked as hard as you did. Everyone can see the good you were doing, Nick, except for you. I hope this is something you're talking about with your therapist.
I am. It's tough, though. There's just so much to talk about.
I imagine so. You were just a teenager when you became a hero, right? Your entire life kind of got put on hold because of that. You can't go back to who you were before becoming Mr. Might because, well, you're not a kid anymore. And your entire adult life has been as a superhero. You haven't had a life out of your costume.
You know, I'm starting to think I didn't have much of a life in costume either.
I'm in no position to judge. Living from crisis to crisis is hell on emotional and personal growth.
You still managed to be there for me. I've gotten a lot of good advice on our talks.
I'm someone who spied on their friend instead of talking to them. I haven't always been there like I should have.
What a pair we are.
I know you're trying, Nick. And I wish I could show you how hard you're trying. I know you're strong enough to keep moving forward. Even when no one knows what the next right step for you is. There's a path out there somewhere, Nick, where you'll be able to put all your good qualities to use.
Yeah, just keep on trying. Everything makes me nervous, though. I still don't know what I'm capable of. And I'm still having weird side effects from whatever that weird explosion did to me. You know, beyond losing my powers, it's exhausting. Not knowing how much of my struggle is from the accident, how much is from my depression and anxiety, and how much is just normal, whatever that is. How do I know what to measure myself against if I don't even know what that is? And even in broad daylight, you pull the vanishing act. Hey, Charlotte, it's Nick. Listen, I'm still not sure about doing anything with the leak, but let's have lunch. I'll fill you in on the details later.